everything I owe you for the first backdrop, plus this one, and even a little something extra, just to count on. I'm gonna miss you so. Jack.
You're a gem.
Just tell me you're going somewhere and not running away.
Does it matter?
If you're going somewhere and it turns out not to be the right place, you can always go somewhere else. But if you're running away, nowhere's ever the right place.
How about letting a pal know you're alive?
Why don't I leave you with your friend?
Where'd you go? We couldn't find you.
Does it think I didn't want to be found?
Is that a real place? Is that Santa Fe? Have you seen the paper? We have front page news above the fold. Oh yes, above the fold. Everyone wants to meet the famous Jack Kelly. Hey, even Spot Conlon sent a kid just to say that next event, you can count on Brooklyn. How about that?
We got stomped to the ground.
Yeah, they got us this time, I'll grant you that. But with press like this, our fight is far from over.
Every newser who could walk showed up this morning to sell papes like the strike never happened.
And I was there with them. If I don't sell papes, my folks don't eat.
Save your breath, I get it. It's hopeless.
But then I saw this look on Weasel's face. He was actually nervous. And I realized that we've got them worried. Really worried. And I walked away. Lots of other kids did too, and that's what you call the beginning.
There he is, just like I said.
For crying out loud, where's a fella gotta go to get away from you people?
There's no escaping his power, we're inevitable.
So, will Meta let us have the theater or not?
Pipe down, I didn't ask you.
What's the deal? I gotta let my girl know if we got a date.
Your girl?
You heard me. I've been swatting skirts away all morning. Fame is one intoxicating potion. And this here girl, Sally, she's a plum.
Yeah.
Word is, you wrote a great story.
You look awful. Hey, Jack, where's that supposed to be?
That's Santa Fe.
I gotta tell you, Jack, this Go West young man routine is getting tired. Even Horace Greeley moved back to New York. Yes, he did. And then he died.
A report is supposed to be nonpartisan.
Ask a reporter. Pulitzer's had me blacklisted on every news desk in town. So, can we table the palaver and get back to business? Will Meta let us have the theater or not?
It's what I've been trying to ask you. We want to hold a rally, a citywide meeting where every newsie gets a say and a vote. And we do it after working hours so no one loses a day's pay. Smart?
Smart enough to get you committed to a padded room.
The person who pays places he's never seen is calling us crazy.
You want to see a place I've seen? Newsy Square, thanks to my big mouth. Filled to overflowing with failure. Kids hurt, others arrested.
Still lighten up. No one died.
Is that what you're aiming for? Go ahead, call me a quitter. Call me a coward. Ain't no way I'm putting those kids back in danger.
Look, we are doing something that's never been done before. How could that not be dangerous?
Specs brought me a letter from Crunchy at the refuge. I tried to see him. Climbed the fire escape. They busted him up so bad, he couldn't even come to the window. What if he don't make it? You willing to show him that? For a tenth of a penny of pain?
It's not about pennies! Jack, you said it yourself. My family wouldn't be in the mess that we're in if my father had a union. This is a fight that we have to win.
If I wanted a sermon, I'd show up for church.
Tell me how quitting does Crutchy any good. Exactly. So here's how it goes. Once we win, then we will be winning. Make no mistake.
We'll be what?
We're already winning. And we'll tell them straight out. They let Crutchy go or they keep getting pounded.
They get a grip. Did they bust up your brains or something? As I recall, did we all got our faces smashed? They won.
Won the battle.
Why?
Jackie, think about it. We've got them surrounded.
Here's what I think. Joe's a jerk. He's a rattlesnake.
You're right. And you know why a snake starts to rattle.
Oh, why?
Cause he's scared. Come and look it up, the poor guy's head is spinning. Why would he send for the goons? An entire army, dozens of goons, plus the cops in.
You know you may be right, thank you God, if he wasn't afraid.
Exactly.
He knows we're winning, get those kids to see what's circling big.
reporters, Mr. Pulitzer. How can you express so much sympathy for the trolley workers and yet have none for the newsies?
Because the trolley workers are striking for a fair contract. The newsies are striking against me.
I would spare you this embarrassment if I could, but the burlesque house is a private property.
You can't order a raid without a legal cause.
Well, the fact that this rally is being organized by an escaped convict will be enough to shut it down.
An escaped convict?
A fugitive from one of your very own institutions, at large, wreaking havoc on our law-abiding community.
Mr. Snyder, which one is he?
That one there, Jack Kelly.
And how do you know this boy?
His is not a pleasant story. He was first sentenced to my refuge for loitering and vagrancy, but his total disregard of authority has made him a frequent visitor.
You called him a thief and escaped convict.
After his release, I caught him myself, red-handed, trafficking stolen food and clothing. He was last sentenced to 6 months, but the willful ruffian escaped.
So, you'd be doing the city a service, getting this criminal off our streets.
In that case, we can take him in, quiet
him.
What
good does quiet do me?
I want a public example made of him.
Mr. Pulitzer, the boy, Jack Kelly, he's here.
Here?
Just outside. He's asked to see you.
Ask and you shall receive.
Mr. Snyder, if you please.
Sit.
Mr. Jack Kelly.
Afternoon, boys.
Now, which Jack Kelly is this? The charismatic union organizer or the petty thief and escaped convict?
Which one gives us more in common?
Impudence is in bad taste when crawling for mercy.
Crawling? That's a laugh. I just came by with an invite. Seems a few hundred of your employees are rallying to discuss recent disagreements. I thought it only fair to give you a chance to state your case straight to the fellas. So what do you say, Joe? Want us to save you a spot on the bill?
You are as shameless and disrespectful a creature as I was told. Do you know what I was doing when I was your age, boy? I was fighting in a war.
Yeah? How'd that turn out for you?
It taught me a lesson that shaped my life forever. The war is not won on the battlefield. It's the headline that crowns the victor.
I'll remember that when New York wakes up to front page photos of our rally.
Rally to the cows come home. Not a paper in town will publish a word. If it's not in the papers, it never happens.
You may run this city, but there's some of us who can't be bullied, even some reporters.
Now, such as that young woman who made you yesterday's news. Talented girl, and beautiful as well, don't you think?
I'll tell her you said so.
No need. She can hear for herself, can't you, darling? Now, I know you tripped on my daughter, Catherine. Yes, my daughter. You're probably asking yourself, why the nom de plume? Why doesn't my daughter work for me? Good questions. I offered Catherine a life of wealth and leisure, and said she chose to pursue a career. Now, she was showing real promise until this recent lapse. But you're done with all that now, aren't you, darling?
Jack, I...
Don't trouble the boy with your problems, dearest. Mr. Kelly has a plate full on his own. Wouldn't you say so, Mr. Snyder?
Hello, Jack.
Does anyone else feel a noose tightening? Now allow me to offer you an alternate scenario. You attend your rally and speak against this hopeless strike, and I'll see enough cash in your pockets to carry you from New York to New Mexico and beyond. You did say you wanted to travel west, didn't you, darling?
There ain't a person in this room who don't know you stink.
If they know me, they know I don't care. Mark my words, boy, defy me, and I will see you and every single one of your friends tossed to the refuge. Now I know you're Mr. Tough Guy, but it's not right to condemn that little crippled boy to conditions like that. What about your pal, Davey, and his little brother, torn from their loving families and tossed to the rats? How could they ever thank you enough? Time's running out, kid, so what do you say? Cowboy or convict, I win either way. Your abject surrender was always the bottom line. Gentlemen, if you could escort our guest to the cellar so he may reflect in solitude. Too bad.
bad you looked short, Jack, but you did resign. Too bad you have family, but you can't have mine. I'm glad you're alive, boy, I'd say that's the bottom line.
Like the Pied Piper, you knew what to play.
Those kids all believed you were right.
From every tape and neighborhood here tonight. Tonight you're making history.
Yeah.
Tonight we show those newspaper owners that we are just as much as part of any tape as any editor or reporter.
Yeah.
We are done being treated like kids.
Yeah.
From now on we will be treated as equals.
Yeah.
You
want to
be treated like an adult? Start acting like one. Don't just run your mouth.
And here's Jack.
Pulitzer raised the price of papers without so much as a word to us. That was a lousy thing to do.
That's right.
Yeah.
So we got mad. Let him know we ain't gonna be pushed around.
That's right.
So we go on strike. Then what? Pulitzer lowers the price so we'll go back to work. And then a few weeks later, he hikes him right back up again. And don't think he won't. So what do we do then? And what do we do when he decides to raise the price again after that? Fellas, we gotta be realistic. We don't work, we don't get paid. How long can you go without making money? However long, believe me, Pulitzer can go longer. But I've spoken with Mr. Pulitzer. He's assured me. disband the union. Disband. We won't raise the price again for another 2 years. Just believe and put it in writing. I say we take the deal. All we have to do is vote no on the strike.
Sticking out of there. I didn't know what they were. These drawings. These are drawings of the refuge, aren't they? Is this really what it's like in there? Three boys to a bed, rats everywhere, and vermin?
A little different from what you were raised.
Snyder told my father you were arrested stealing food and clothing. This is why, isn't it? You stole to feed those boys. I don't understand, Jack. If you were willing to go to jail for those boys, how can you turn your back on them now?
You don't want to talk about turning your back on folks.
I never turned on you, or anyone else.
No, you just double-crossed us to your father. Your father!
My father has eyes on every corner of this city. He doesn't need me spying for him. And I never lied. I didn't tell you everything.
If you want a girl, you'd be trying to talk with a fist in your mouth.
I said I worked for the Sun, and I do. I told you my professional name was Plumber, and it is! You never asked my real one.
You shouldn't think I had to, unless I knew I was dealing with a backstabber.
And if I were a boy, you'd be looking through one swollen eye!
Don't let that stop it! Give me your best shot!
I need to know you didn't cave for the money.
I spoke the truth. You won a fight when you got the other guy down eating pavement. And besides, you heard your father. No matter how long we strike, he's never given up. I don't know what else we can do.
But I do.
Oh, come on.
Really, Jack? Really? Only you can have a good idea? Or is it because I'm a girl?
Hold on. I never said that
you... Now would be a good time to shut up. Being boss doesn't mean you have all the answers. Just the brains to recognize the right ones when you hear it.
Right, I'm listening.
Good for you. The strike was your idea, the rally was Davies, and now my plan will take us to the finish line. Deal with it.
The children's crusade?
For the sake of every worker in all the sweatshop, factory, and slaughterhouses in New York, I beg you, join us. With those words, the strike stopped being just about the newsies. You challenged our whole generation to take a stand and demand a place at the table.
The Children's Crusade?
Think, Jack. If we publish this, my words with one of your drawings, and if every worker under 21 read it and stayed home from work, or better yet, came to the Newsy Square, a general-wide strike. Even my father couldn't ignore that one.
Yeah, but there's only one problem. We got no way to print it.
Come on, there has to be one printing press he doesn't control.
Oh no.
What?
I know it is a printed press no one will ever think we'll use.
Then why are we still standing here?
Wait, stop. What's this about? I ain't talking about no children's crusade. I mean, what's this about? Am I kidding myself or is there something?
Well, of course there is.
Well, don't just say it like it happens every day.
Oh, Jack.
I'm not stupid. I know girls like you don't wind up with guys like me. And I don't want you promising something you're gonna have to take back tomorrow. But standing here tonight looking at you, I'm scared tomorrow's gonna come and change everything. Maybe there was a way I could grab a hold of something to make time stop, just so I could keep looking at you.
You snuck up on me, Jack. I never even saw it coming.
For sure?
For sure.
Jack, this is Darcy.
He knows just about everything there is to know about printing.
Yeah, suppose you work for one of the papes too, eh?
My father owns the Trip.
Whoa.
And this is Bill. He'll be typesetting the article for us.
Bill, huh? I suppose you're the son of William Randolph Hearst.
I'm proud to be part of your revolution.
In the words of the little one, can we table the palaver and get down to business?
With a little bit of grease, should be good as gold.
Guy, here's how important. Race you with the rest of the fellows. I'm gonna take these to every working kid in New York. After that?
After that, it's up to them.
There's change coming once and for all. You mix the front page and then you is major news. Tomorrow they'll see what we are, and sure as a star, we ain't come this far.
Early light, you'll be ready to fight us a war. This time we're in it to stay. Talk about seizing the day.
Writing in ink or in blood, it's the same in a way. Vacancy will pay.
And when politics come in his bed, we don't care if we're dead or alive. His hand pillows are under his head, while he's begging for bread to survive. So you can stop counting sheep. We're gonna sing, get a sweep.
Then all your shoes will be lying and abused with the promise we they give the king.
Once and for all, if they don't mind the manners, we'll bleed up.
Bleed up. Freedom. Finally we're raising the stakes. This time whatever it takes. It's time to use.
Union leader Jack Kelly, we will work with you. We will even work for you, but we will be paid and treated as valuable members of your organizations. Riveting stuff, huh?
Yeah. Get going. We got a very important man to see.
Your fingers crossed.
For both of us.
This is for kids shining shoes on the street with no shoes on their feet every day. This is for guys sweating blood in the shops while their bosses and cops look away. I'm seeing kids standing tall, glaring rare in the brawl. Armies of guys who are sick of the lies, getting ready to rise to the call. Once and for all, there'll be blood on the wall if they doubt us. They think they're running this town, but this town will shut down without us. Look at all the kids in the square.
Yeah.
Show you who's gonna win there. Once and for all.
arrest those folks.
The entire city is shut down. No one is working anywhere, and they're all blaming you.
They're all calling the publisher, the manufacturers, and such language.
You can't just march in.
How are we doing this morning, gents?
You're behind us. We had a deal.
And it came with a money-back guarantee. Thanks for your advice on the power of press.
Did you read this, boss? These kids put out a pretty good paper.
No doubt written by my daughter.
I'd sign it before someone else grabs her up.
I demand to know who went against my ban on strike material.
We're your loyal employees. We never take our business elsewhere.
The old printing press in the cellar.
I gave you the offer of a lifetime. Anyone who does not act on their own self-interest is a fool.
Then what's that make you? This all started because you wanted to sell more papers, but now your circulation's down 70%. Why didn't you just come talk to us?
Guys like Joe don't talk to nothings like us. But a very wise reporter once told me that a good boss don't need the answers, just the smarts to snatch the right one up when he hears it.
Now is the time to seize the day. Stare down the odds and seize the day. Minute by minute, that's how you win it. We will find our way under the sea.
Thanks, you had notes, Mr. Pulitzer. He's got you surrounded.
New York is closed for business. Paralyzed. You can't buy a paper or get a shoe shine. You can't send a message or ride an elevator or cross the Brooklyn Bridge. You can't even leave your own building. So what's your next move, Joe?
Mr. Pulitzer, the mayor's here along with your daughter, and well, you're not going to believe who else.
Mr. Pulitzer, I think you know the governor.
Governor Roosevelt.
Joseph, Joseph, Joseph. What have you done now?
I'm sure we can hear my explanation.
Thanks to the lovely Miss Metalargan, I have a thorough grasp of the situation at hand. Graphic illustration included. Bully is the expression I usually employ to show approval, but in your case, I simply mean bully. Ah, and is this the boy of whom you spoke? How are you, son? I'm told we shared a carriage ride together.
Much as mine, Mr. Governor.
Well, Joe, don't just stand there letting those children sing on endlessly. Give us the good news.
What good news?
Why, that you've come to your senses to roll back prices. Unless, of course, you want to invite a full state senate investigation into your employment practices.
You wouldn't.
After the pressure you wielded to keep me from office, why? I do it with a smile. Come along, Joseph. The one thing worse than a hard heart is a soft head. Plus, think of all the happiness you'll bring those children. He doesn't do happiness, does he?
Mr. Kelly, if I may speak to you, alone.
Hey, keep your eyes on the stars and your feet on the ground. You can do this.
I cannot put the prices back to what they were. I'm sorry, but there are other considerations.
I get it. You gotta save face in front of all these folks. I'm young, I ain't stupid.
Thank you for understanding.
But I got constituents with a legitimate gripe.
What if I reduce the raise by half and get the others to do the same? It's a compromise we can all live with.
Then you cut our losses. From now on, any paper a newsie can't sell, you buy back, full price.
That was never on the table. What's to stop newsies from taking hundreds of papers they can't sell?
No,
my costs would explode.
No newsie is gonna break his back hauling around papers he can't sell. But if he can take a few more with no risk, he might sell them, and your circulation will begin to grow. It's a compromise we can all live with.
It's not a bad hedge you've got on your shoulders.
Deal?
That's disgusting.
Just the price of doing business.
Thank you.
future in your hands will be bright and prosperous. And your drawing, son, I brought another man to bear. Officers, if you please. Abuses will be fully investigated. Officers, take him away!
Oh, please, Your Highness. May I do the honors?
Say, Teddy, want to let this young man's artistry shine a lantern behind your closed doors?
Don't sweat it, Governor. With the strike settled, I'll be hitting the road.
Don't you ever get tired of singing the same old tone? What Santa Fe got the New York game? Sandstorms?
Or better yet, what's New York got that Santa Fe and New York's got us? And we're a family.
Now, didn't I hear something about a strike being settled?
Pipes for the noses! Line up, boys. These pipes ain't gonna sell themselves.
Come along, Governor. Show me this back seat I've been hearing so much about. Oh, don't just stand there. You've got a union to run. And besides, didn't I just hear someone offering you a pretty exciting job?
What's your father?
Much to be a dreamer, all you do is close your eyes. Some made-up world is all you see. Now my eyes is finally open, and my dreams, they have its size.
Thank you. Thank you.